Hello there. Welcome to my today's presentation. Today, I'm going to discuss lymphoma in dogs. Is it cancer? That's the question I always get when I alert a client that his or her dog has lymphoma. Is it cancer? This is video one in this series of videos in which I'll be discussing cancer of the white blood cells. So I'll be discussing lymphomas today. Then later I'm going to discuss leukemias and the myelomas in dogs and cats. So what is lymphoma? Lymphoma is a cancer of the white blood cells. Which blood cells, you may ask? The bone marrow produces red and white blood cells plus platelets. Lymphoma affects the lymphocytes line of white blood cells. Lymphoma specifically attacks the B and T lymphocytes. The letters B and T stand for bone marrow, because the B lymphocytes are producing the bone marrow, and T stands for the thymus, because the T lymphocytes mature in the thymus, and from there they are called the T lymphocytes, T standing for thymus. B cells produce antibodies which patrol the blood and lymph circulation systems, looking for specific antigens to neutralize. After production in the bone marrow, some immature lymphocytes travel to the thymus, where they mature and become T lymphocytes. T lymphocytes patrol the blood and lymph circulation systems like the B cells. High concentrations of B and T lymphocytes are found in all the lymph nodes, the spleen, and the skin. How does lymphoma develop? B and T lymphocytes are part of the delayed immune system and are always in contact with antigens in their defensive duties. That contact makes them vulnerable and prone to mutations. Lymphoma develops when a single B or T cell mutates and starts multiplying uncontrollably. The characteristic sign of lymphoma is swollen and painless peripheral lymph nodes. Let's look at that. So there's a diagram of a dog showing both the peripheral and the internal lymph nodes. If you start right there at the head, you have parotid lymph nodes, you have some mandibular lymph nodes, you have scapular lymph nodes just ahead of the shoulder there, you have axillary lymph nodes in the armpits of the dog, right? You have retropharyngeal lymph nodes, you have the tracheal lymph duct, lymphatic duct, got the thoracic duct here. Then you have got bronchial lymph nodes inside the chest. You have mesenteric lymph nodes in the abdomen. You have inguinal lymph nodes, superficial inguinal lymph nodes or peripheral lymph nodes. Then you have popliteal lymph nodes on the medial side of the thighs. So those are peripheral lymph nodes, internal lymph nodes, peripheral lymph node, Others are peripheral lymph nodes. Alright, there's an image of a swollen lymph node in this dog that had lymphoma, right? A swollen submandibular lymph node. Dogs with swollen lymph nodes. Dogs with peripheral, with the swollen peripheral lymph nodes you have swollen internal lymph nodes and that's red. Lymphoma could originate from any of the component organs of the immune system, as the lymph nodes, the spleen, the thymus, the skin, or the bone marrow. For that reason, lymphoma is described as multicentric, right? That is, the cancer could start from any one of the lymph nodes or any one of the other organs that is part of the immune system. Lymphoma could affect other organs like the liver and other organs of the digestive system. How is lymphoma diagnosed? Clinical signs, x-rays, needle aspirate, and tissue biopsy will lead to the correct diagnosis. Okay, there's a result of a needle aspirate of a dog that had the swollen peripheral lymph nodes. The diagnosis was lymphoma. And the description, the microscopic description is the cells, if I read it, the cells are predominantly medial to large lymphocytes and the lymphoblasts with the prominent multiple nuclei and the basopheric cytoplasm. Occasional mitotic figures are seen. And there goes the diagnosis of lymphoma. Alright, these are images of a normal lymphocyte. These are the images of a cancerous lymphocyte. You can see the difference. They are in the status of multiplication. This has four nuclei there. This has how many? Three to four. About three. Just about starting to develop. This one has two. This one has a lobulated. It could be one, two, three, four, five. All right. So you can see how fast the cancerous cells are multiplying. So you can see their shape is a little bit different. Normal cells have just one single nuclear here they have got different nuclei because they are multiplying extremely fast. That's why they are cancerous. How is lymphoma treated? As mentioned earlier, lymphoma described as multicentric. It could originate from any part of the body, the component organs of the immune system or the liver, or any part of the digestive system. So it could have different masses everywhere in the body. So the best treatment for lymphoma is chemotherapy. Chemotherapy will be able to attack all the masses and all the cancer cells everywhere, wherever they are developing. And that's the end of the video. If this video was helpful, to subscribe, share it, comment, or ask a question below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.